The only way to lose weight for me. A few weeks ago, I went to see the doctor for the first time in a few years. Yeah, I know, I should probably go more often. I was going for something unrelated, but the doctor decided to weigh me at the end of the consultation. He found that I was about 78 kilograms, and at 178 centimeters tall, he calculated my body mass index, BMI, to be approximately 24.6. The healthy range for BMI is between 18.5 and 24.9, so I'm towards the upper end. You would be considered overweight if your BMI was between 25.0 and 29.9, and anything greater than that would be considered obese. Although I'm in the healthy range, he recommended that for my build and body type, I should probably try to lose some weight. He recommended that I cut down to about 72 kg. At 72 kg, my BMI would be 22.7, a much nicer figure. Now, even though I'm a fairly active guy, I find it extremely hard to lose weight. And I think this is probably true for most Westerners. I don't necessarily blame individuals, I think the Western lifestyle has a big part to play. Most of my friends are overweight now, if not obese, both young and old. But when I was a kid, I knew very few overweight adults. It was actually kind of rare. There's something about our modern lifestyles that is conducive with being overweight. Back in 2001, before I moved to Japan for the first time, I was about the same weight as I am today, 78 kg. When I first came back to Australia in 2003, I was only 73 kg, a whole 5 kilograms lighter. Actually, a few people commented that I was a lot thinner and looking quite good. I did nothing special to lose that weight, I just existed in Japan. That goes to tell me that there was something particular about my Japanese lifestyle that naturally helped me lose weight. Unsurprisingly, after staying in Australia for a number of months after, I put all the weight back on again. The same thing happened in 2004 when I moved back to Japan. It also happened again when I moved to China in 2008. I identified that the only common thing between my lifestyle in China and Japan was that I was walking or riding everywhere, and that I was eating a lot of rice and vegetables. Since coming back to Australia, I've gone back up to 78 kilograms. I've gone through a few periods of trying to lose weight, and now know what works and what doesn't work. First of all, what doesn't work? Exercise. Now, don't get me wrong, exercise has many benefits, but it is not a very efficient way to lose weight for the average Australian. I used to go to the park every morning and do lots of push-ups, handstands, running, jumping, and other intensive activities. What did I find after doing that for a couple of months? I hadn't lost a single kg. Not a single one. After doing a bit of research, I realized what was going on. Although I was burning more energy per day than I was previously, I was probably also eating more due to my increased hunger. And that's the catch with exercise. It's very hard to burn off extra calories. I'm sure you've heard the one where you have to run for a full hour to burn off a hamburger and chips. Most people actually put on a little weight after a session at the gym. It's very easy for us to overestimate how much energy we've actually burnt. Exercise is great, but it's an inefficient form of weight loss. So that leaves us with diet. The only other way to lose weight is to modify your diet, i.e., you have to eat less. Now I try to eat less at each meal. It just doesn't work. When I sit down to eat dinner, I eat until I feel satisfied. Sometimes I might overeat a little, but all in all, I must consume approximately the same number of calories each day, as I don't put on any weight. But that's not what I want to do. I want to lose weight. I tried limiting the food that I have at each meal, but I just feel hungry. I can maybe keep it up for a couple of days, but ultimately, hunger kicks in and I eat more. The only way that I've found that I can consistently lose weight, at least while I'm living in Australia, is to skip meals, i.e. fasting. Yes, I know, all the traditional advice recommends against this, but quite frankly, nothing else works. I think the whole idea of 3 square meals a day is wrong. I think that encourages us to overeat. I found that I can't go to bed hungry, so I have to eat dinner every night. But I found that I don't feel hungry in the mornings. It's extremely easy for me not to eat breakfast. Over the last couple of weeks, I've only been eating a tiny breakfast, usually just finishing off my children's leftover cereal or fruit. So that equates to a couple of spoons of Weet-Bix or maybe an apple. Then I walk to work, which takes me about 40 minutes, and work my 5-hour shift. I don't feel hungry during the day as I'm too busy to think about food. I get home at about 3:30 and yes, I feel hungry. But if I can force myself to wait till dinner time, I feel satisfied after dinner and I go to bed happy. But most importantly, I lose weight. I've attempted to not eat any breakfast as well as skipping lunch, but I find myself getting lightheaded at work. I presume this is to do with low blood sugar, so as long as I eat a small breakfast, I can easily work through the day without eating. On my days off, when I'm not walking to work, I just skip breakfast completely as it doesn't interrupt me at home. I may have a small lunch, but nothing more than a salad or a piece of fruit. And then finally, I have a full dinner, and I lose weight. So that's my secret. A small breakfast or a small lunch, plus a full dinner. And definitely no snacking. And of course, I keep doing a moderate amount of exercise. Pretty simple, I know, but it works for me. In the last 2 weeks, I'm down to 75 kg from a peak of 78 kg, and that's after having attended a number of food-laden Christmas parties. I hope this video has been informative. If you have any other ideas how to lose weight, I'm all ears. Cheers.